good to go. Hey y'all, what's up? It's your girl Jay.
I did the Shador Sanders. It's a new thing.
How's your friend?
Anywho, we apologize, guys. It's been a couple weeks. I know you missed us. We missed you too. And we are back with our shenanigans. We have a few topics we would like to discuss. What should we start with?
Whatever you feel.
He was all amped in the group chat. Like, he had some shit to say.
So, as you know, I'm on TikTok, right? And I posted up some snippets. Nothing crazy, right? They get good views. You know, a couple thousand. Ain't nothing crazy. But good enough, right? It was just something about, you know, how women fall in love during relationships. And sometimes, as far as, like, how people get too comfortable in relationships.
Oh, okay.
I speak...
Oh, yeah, women, that happens to them first.
Yeah, right? Some fucking bitch decided to fucking shame me.
Jesus.
She told me I was fat and ugly. Two things about that. Not fat. I'm definitely not ugly. That's number one. Number two, I'm not a fucking woman. I don't care. Only women care about that shit. You call a girl fat and ugly, she's gonna fucking cry at night. Me, I don't give a fuck. Because if I'm rich... Give us a fuck if I'm fat and ugly. I got fucking money. What do you got?
There's guys who care about gaining weight.
But I'm not fat and ugly, so I don't really give a fuck. So, I was just like, shut up. And then she's like, oh, you don't love yourself. Bitch, you don't. You clearly don't know me. Because if you know me, you know I love myself. So, like, she was just saying shit to say shit. And then they was just like, her and some fucking unknown face... bitch tried fucking chiming in, and I'm just like, both of you need to shut the fuck up. And I did this Shador Sanders, just put up my wrist. I don't got a watch, but just put up my wrist. That's just a nice way of saying fuck you. Just like, I don't care. You're gonna try and
tries to flick off. I'm done with him. All right. So we need to stop taking too long to record because clearly it affects him. All right. So let's start with. Since we're talking about getting comfortable in relationships, let's go with marriages.
What a transition.
Right.
What a segue.
Let's just go right into it. Should we start with Papoose and Remy, or should we go with Jenny Mai and Jeezy?
Which one do you know more about?
I kind of know a little about both.
Why did I just ask a woman how much tea?
Period.
Dude, I'm not going to lie. I'm not going to lie. Since we're on the topic... I didn't even know Young Jeezy's wife's name until she said it. I just called her Young Jeezy's wife.
Same.
I just called her Jeezy's wife.
It's weird because I think somehow in some weird way she's famous.
She's a co-host on The View. Mm-hmm.
How much of this was before Jeezy?
She was on The View for a while.
Oh, okay.
Even with her ex-husband, she was on The View. That's what I'm trying to tell you. Like, so which one you guys want to start with? Because I know.
Apparently, you know.
Is that the one with Whoopi?
That's because I did a little research.
Is that the one with Whoopi Goldberg?
Yes.
You know what's crazy about Whoopi Goldberg? I'm not gonna lie. I just found her like 3 years ago. She has no eyebrows.
What?
Yeah, tattooed.
No, she has zero. She has no eyebrows. I just learned that like 3 years ago.
She has, like, none.
No, I just learned that 3 years ago.
That was really random.
Well, you're talking about The View. That's all I fucking know it's on. I don't watch that shit. I just know Whoopi Goldberg's on it.
Well, kudos to her for having the face.
That's Miss Seeley. All
right.
Never noticed.
Okay.
So, if you ever want to look up Whoopi Goldberg, just look. She has no eyebrows.
I think I'm going to do it just for the fun of it.
She has no fucking eyebrows. I just learned that shit like 3 years ago. Yeah. Apparently, it's always been like that.
That's what I said. Kudos to her. Because nobody's ever noticed.
Definitely did not.
I feel like she has prominent eyebrows. Like, I feel like we would have noticed.
Yeah,
that.
She really.
She don't got no fucking eyebrows.
That's crazy.
Neither does Doja Cat. So.
Nah, Doja Cat is a different level. All right, so listen, ADHD kicking in. Let's go back to Jenny Mai and Jeezy. So, all right. The biggest take that I was finding interesting on YouTube was the fact that a lot of people was covering. Okay.
Just to make our lives a little bit. So that fucking why I can't find the the wire, but not the battery part.
What the hell?
That's why I'm like, what? These two things should be with each other. Like.
All right, so Jenny Mai and Jeezy. I think the most interesting take that everybody's been buzzing around YouTube with is the fact that, you know how, like, in height of the Passport Bros, in the whole movement of men looking to date.
I think it's great.
Okay, that's great. But the part of men looking to date outside their race, and, like, black men exploring options of white women and Asian women, stating how, like, the stereotypical, you know, they're more feminine, they're more.
Yeah. You know what's so funny about Passport Bros? I want you to stay on topic with Jenny Mai. But what I think is so funny about Passport Bros is there's mad men that do it, like, to Africa, and they never get talked about.
True.
Because that would defeat the purpose.
Correct.
Like, what do you have to say? I went to the motherland to go find a better one.
Right. Well, you know, like Eddie Murphy says, that's what he would do.
Big Bush bitch.
Mm-hmm. And then just don't let her mix with the American women.
What
cause
have
then
you done for me lately, Eddie?
Yeah, I mean, it's true. It's true. Is she from here? Is she from here?
Who? Jenny Mai?
Yeah.
I believe so. I believe she's first generation Asian American.
She doesn't count, but go ahead.
Whatever. Either way. Point of the matter is that they were stating how, like, Asian and Caucasian women are, like, more submissive, more feminine, and things of that nature. And that's why most black men will look to date outside their race for those specific ethnicities. So with the fact that Jeezy, who, if I'm not mistaken, has multiple kids and multiple baby mamas and decided to marry her, and then now they're divorcing, not even, what, 2 years?
Has it been 2 years?
Like a year or two in?
I don't know.
I kind of skipped that part. Everybody's, like, in a frenzy because they're like, see, not even Asian women or all that other stuff.
She's American, though.
Which goes to the other point about the Passport Bro conversation, because there's that one particular Passport Bro from Texas that is viral on TikTok, and he always says, don't even date American women at all. Like, doesn't matter.
It has nothing to do with the ethnicity. It has nothing to do with dating an Asian woman, dating a white woman. It is the concept of Passport Bro.
But
American women,
shit,
first generation.
Damn, that's what he's saying. That's what he's saying.
That's not what I'm saying. But you down that hill by yourself.
But the point I wanted to kind of touch, which was interesting, was she is American, but she is first generation. And first generation Americans, we tend to be still very close to culture.
But you go to American schools, right?
Yeah, but I mean,
you fraternize with the American people,
right?
So then you're American. It doesn't matter how much you stick to your culture.
Yeah.
You're not. You don't have. All right, cool. I'll give you a perfect example. A Middle Eastern woman that lives in the United States.
Mm-hmm.
If she was to walk into the middle of the street right now and take off her
hijab.
She just took off her hijab.
Mm-hmm.
In America. Over there.
Yeah. It's totally different.
It's same culture.
Mm-hmm.
It's the same offense.
Mm-hmm.
It is handled differently
mm-hmm.
on the other coast.
Mm-hmm.
Wouldn't get handled here at all.
Right.
Because honestly, like, who, a girl walks in the middle of the street, takes off her job, who gives a fuck? In America, who gives a fuck?
In America, if she does that in the middle of the street, if there's enough other women around, they're going to encourage it, knowing nothing about
her. You go, sis.
Exactly. Knowing nothing about, knowing, not knowing she's writing her own death warrant.
Right.
Because they don't understand the culture. Mm-hmm. But that's because we're here, mm-hmm. and we think the world thinks like we do, and that's not how it works anywhere else. That's why I said the Passport Bro thing, that's a false parallel. What that is that's people using a incident that has a small comparison
mm-hmm.
to inflate the problem that the thing that they have an issue with, which is the Passport Bro
mm-hmm.
things. But again, Jeezy was married to a first generation American Asian woman.
Mm-hmm.
She's American.
Yeah.
Which is why, again, she's American, which is why they had an issue over her fighting for what she wants to happen.
Mm-hmm.
Because here it's okay to disobey your husband. If husband says no over there, then no, you're not walking the kids to school.
Right.
It's different. It's different.
Sorry, my back.
Yeah, it's different.
I understand. The anger may be the same as far as people having an issue with people dating outside of their race or whatever.
So it wasn't being an issue.
However people side on that, you know how I feel about that, but however people side on that is how they side on it, but...
I'll say this. Should have worn my snowman shirt, number one. Number two, Trap or Die 4 is going to be fucking crazy.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God.
Them bars.
Oh, my God. And then number three.
Them bars left the streets. Jesus should have been. She sent me back to the street. Oh, the bars are going to be crazy.
And three, Jesus should have been friends with me because I would have told you to stay the fuck away.
Oh, my God. Every episode.
We should let him. Why?
Because they're fucking no good.
Who's no good?
These American women, they're fucking terrible to deal with, too. They're fucking nightmares, trust me. They're fucking nightmares.
Any particular?
Yeah, one. fucking nightmare. Fucking, like, grinds my gears. Like, you're going to see it. Listen. And honestly, obviously, the way Jesus is feeling, it's not just one fucking person. It seems like it's a large amount of them because, honestly...
Papoose and Remy.
Wait, they were married?
They've been married.
They're the fucking symbol of black love.
Yeah,
sir.
Apparently not. But yeah, so was Will. So was Will and Jada.
You know
how'd that fucking turn out?
That marriage. Like, I don't even analyze. Like, you know what I'm saying? But like, I just love them. Like,
why?
Just off the fact of like how much Papoose really like sits there and just like. You know what I'm saying? And, like, he really held her the fuck down. Like, he did what most women do.
Like, so he's a good guy.
He's a great guy.
And he got cheated on.
Come on.
Oh, wow.
Imagine that.
Whoa. Whoa.
They said that they were separated.
Talk right now. Imagine.
Whoa. Whoa, a good guy you're fucking.
Cheated on by a broken woman. Imagine
wow.
That story.
Wow. Papu should fuck the girl she shot.
That's what I would do.
That's what I would do.
Taking her down.
I'm really sad about it though, honestly, because I really love them.
I'm taking her down. Yeah. While I'm listening to Conceited and take you home.
What a fucking.
Want to take me home?
What a fucking.
I was up in the club, right?
She, on top of that, she cheated on him with Papoose with a beard.
Buck teeth
beard Papoose. That's all she did. What the fuck? She cheated on him with a guy who actually looks like a Papoose.
Wow.
Yo.
Wow. That was violent.
What's he gonna?
I'm like, you got bars.
I don't care. I don't know that guy. What was his name? Geechee? What was his name? No, that's the guy who said it. What's his name?
Oh, Easy to Block Captain.
Yeah, whatever. Who gives a fuck?
Easy is correct. Nah, but that's crazy, though. You guys think she really did?
Yeah, of course she did.
My thing is this. I'll say this. I don't know if it's true or not.
Oh, her face said it all.
Oh, listen. Now I'm talking as a battle rap fan. I don't know if it's true or not. But I know certain reactions in battle rap.
Oh, shit.
Mean a lot. It's hard for the league owners. A lot of times, battle rappers, they talk shit to the league owners. That's part of it. Like, niggas talk shit to Smack all the time.
Mm-hmm.
You gotta just sit there and take it.
Mm-hmm.
There's certain shit, though, that certain faces. Her and her homegirl. Her homegirl moved the girl that was standing next to Remy out the way and stood next to Remy and had the same stank face that Remy. Like, only your close friends know the truth about you.
Not only that.
So for your friend to hold on, because for your friend to be as mad as you are in the moment and it's visible, that said something to me. That's why I'm like, I don't know if this is true, but something's true. Because
they were saying that like they've been separated for a bit.
I will tell you what gave it away. When he's doing his little thing, right? He's saying the whole thing about thing. And he said, yo, Pap. Pap said, yes, sir.
That wasn't really Pap.
Was it really? No. That's what he said.
No. So what happened was, that's battle rap. In the beginning of that little snippet he did, he said something about A-Verb versus Hitman. In that battle, A-Verb was talking to Hitman like he was his father. And his father just so happened to be in the crowd. So Ava was like, "Hey, Big Gerald." And the nigga answered. Was like, "Yes, sir." And he was like, "That's the way you talk to your son." And it just hit different because it was him. You know what I mean? So that's what Geechee kind of redid that. So that wasn't really Papoose, but all battle rap fans understood what he was doing in that moment. That's why he prefaced it. Was like,
But her face was like, damn.
Nah, no bullshit. As a female, like, I seen her face. I said, ooh.
Yeah, that's the, because supposedly, and again, I don't know this because it's rumored.
Allegedly,
they had Geechee try to sign an NDA. They tried to have Geechee sign an NDA to specifically not talk about that in his round. Geechee a nigga from Compton. He don't care. He battle raps for sport. Mm-hmm. He don't give a fuck. Like, that's why he kept saying this back. He said, "Nigga trying to make me sign an NDA so I wouldn't say nothing." And he was like, "Nigga, that shit stood for, nigga, you should have ducked at least when Papoose hit him."
Papoose hit him?
Supposedly, Papoose knocked him out.
Allegedly. You know who needs to get knocked out? Well, actually, the judge knocked his ass out with home confinement. Fucking Nicki Minaj.
Oh, yeah. What's up with that? I don't follow anything that happens with
Yeah,
that.
I don't follow.
All right. So, at the BET Award or whatever, when...
That's all I know about him.
We know.
That's all I know about him.
So, at the BET Awards, Nicki was on stage. She performed her...
Midlife Crisis?
She performed her latest single off of, I guess, a new album or whatever that she's about to drop or some shit like
the
that.
The Safari Rate, this one?
So, Cardi B and them were backstage. I think it was Cardi B and Meg Thee Stallion. And I meant to say husband.
Her peasant?
Was about to say that, but like
her charity case.
You know, like, listen, the homeboy was with his boy in the backstage, and like basically they were just like talking like slick shit. You know what I'm saying? They posted on Instagram. Cardi B ended up tweeting talking about like no one flinched or some shit like that. Like I forgot exactly what, you know. Don't quote me exactly. So Cardi B replied to that. They insinuated that was like Cardi B replying to him, and then so they go back on Instagram and, you know, put up more stories or whatever, talking shit. And then allegedly Offset ended up sliding in the husband's friend's DM, and then like they were talking shit or whatever. And then the husband and his boy was outside New York or whatever, and they were just like talking about grown ass men talking about how they own the block and all that other shit. So you know, the judge said, "All right, bet, say less," and put him on home confinement.
Yeah, honestly, I'm not wasting my time with someone who can't be 10 feet. Like,
and that was a petty thing that someone, one of the fans did put. They put a picture of Offset with his daughter going, and they were like, that they're not about to go back and forth with a man who can't even bring his kid to school or some shit like that.
That's what I'm saying. I'm not wasting my time.
Yo, the fans wasted no time. The fans wasted no time. Same here, bro.
I'm not wasting my time with someone who can't be 10 feet of a Chuck E. Cheese. Wait, what the fuck?
Yeah, nah, not being allowed out of Chuck E. Cheese is crazy, bro.
Yeah. That's crazy. But so, like...
So are we able to address the bigger issue that's actually going on here? All that fake sisterhoodism is just crumbling, because all the girlies are beefing. Like, it's not just them two.
Oh, you mean
the girlies are beefing.
Who else is beefing?
Oh yeah, because Lotto's beefing with Ice Spice.
All the girlies is
beefing. Wait, Lotto and Ice Spice are beefing?
Yeah.
They just need to settle it with a twerk off. I'd watch that. Because
they were saying that
Lotto's smoking Ice Spice.
Mm-hmm.
Because what do you call it? They were saying that that coochie swipe thing is Ice Spice, and Lotto was doing it before her.
That's what we're mad about.
That's what it's mad about. That's what it stemmed from. Yeah.
Mad about coochie swipes.
Yeah.
Nobody's like,
pose.
And you know what's crazy? Right? While all these girls are having a little cat fight, Sexy Red's doing this.
You know what? I was just about to break her musty. dusty, crusty. She just looks musty. Like, I can't get over it. Oh my god. No, because that shit really bothers me. Like, I can't unsee the fucking Young Thug in her. Like, I just can't unsee it. Like, what the fuck?
Think she knows Nelly?
Nelly?
Yeah.
Why?
She's from St. Louis. Louis?
Yeah. Probably. Fuck. I don't
maybe
know.
She's a Saint lunatic.
She looked like one. Anyways. But yeah, it's
gross.
Honestly, you know what's really sad about this whole hip hop generation that we have going?
Huh? Sucks.
Well, besides that.
That's the obvious.
Yeah, like, I'm sorry. The 90s, early 2000s, that was just a perfect time for music, television, and everything.
I will be fair. There are some sneaky goats scattered throughout this new generation.
Oh, yeah.
But they're busy catering to the sound of music that exists right now.
Correct.
When music switches up, there's a certain couple of key names that I know will survive.
Like who?
Only because he's not a rapper, Uzi.
Okay, yeah.
He's
facts.
Surviving.
Yep.
What is his name? Cordae? Is that his name?
Yeah. Oh,
Cordae.
Yeah,
you know what I'm talking about, right?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. He's him.
Okay.
Who else? As far as the girly side, a lot of the singers are doing really good. I can't have.
Well, yeah, the singers.
Rap wise, Lotto makes it past the other round.
Yeah, I could see Lotto.
Makes it past the other round.
Lola Brooke
makes it past.
Lola Brooke. I Doja, fucking sweat her. I love her.
The rest of them, they're
when I tell you I love Lola Brooke, she reminds me so much of Foxy Brown. It's not even funny.
Yeah, I think that's what she's going for.
Right? And you know what? It's she's working for her. It's working for her.
She just redid something, didn't
yes.
she?
Yes.
Never happened to Foxy
was
Brown.
Was the LL Cool J joint?
Yes.
They're doing it and doing it. Yeah. They just redid that and it sound
crazy. Fire. Right? And, like, she also has this other song. It's a little older, I think. Dummy Yummy. Like, listen, when I tell Lola Brooke and Teyana Taylor, I don't really get groupied out for really anybody, but, like.
I think the world groupies out for Teyana
Taylor. Yo, facts. Because Teyana Taylor is just undefeated.
There's three women in my mind that, like, is what Angel looks like. And
she's
Janelle
one.
Monáe and Teyana Taylor are two of them.
I want to know, whatever happened to Foxy Brown?
I believe she's deaf now.
Is she deaf?
Allegedly, I don't know. Don't misquote me.
I haven't heard.
I think
she has
medical things going on. If I'm not mistaken,
I haven't heard from no pun intended. I haven't heard from her in a while.
Yeah, no, because I fucked with Foxy. Foxy little.
That's what I'm saying.
Like,
I haven't heard like
top two.
My favorite song by Foxy is "Sleeper" though. That shit with her and SZA. The reggae joint.
Yeah.
With me. Nigga, her verse on
yeah.
that shit is crazy.
She made some shit.
I'm not, but like, let's talk about this. Because, like, you know, a lot of us, I guess not a lot of us apparently in this generation, but like marriages is something that's really hard these days. And the numbers have plummeted for quite some time, really at the peak and rise of.
Sick how commonly divorce is
talking. Yes. Like, and that's where I was going
to
go.
After my first divorce, and I'm just like,
yeah, and I was going
to. Why are you not still sad?
You know, and honestly, and that's what I wanted to talk about. Because, like, for example, look at even Teyana Taylor. Like, Iman. How, like, that whole side chick situation or whatever. And they've been separated for a while. She ended up coming in his defense. I know. No. But I'm saying, like, a lot of people were naming it. Like, oh, this was the side chick until she came up.
Because people don't know how to mind their own fucking business.
Well, that too. I mean, it's social media, damn it.
Like, with the Jeezy, and Jenny Mai shit. Wasn't there, like, at first it was cheating rumors? It was which one cheated?
The dude from Saved by the Bell.
They were saying that she cheated.
With the guy from Saved by the Bell.
They were saying that, and then it's just like, so it couldn't be nothing else. It had to be cheating.
But that's what I was saying. Like, relationships do drift apart for reasons
then
outside of infidelity.
Out, then shit comes out, and it's just cultural and people differences. And now we're, well, these passport bros, and it, like, y'all just need an issue. They just didn't work. Now, in situations like that, I get it. In situations like that, I understand, yo, these are two people that are from two completely different worlds. So they're not going to work as a unit.
Mm-hmm.
Your worlds have to have some type of commonality in order for
you to survive. Yeah, I 100% agree that.
And when you, my fault, but when you get past the part that most people are running after, which is the money,
mm-hmm.
because y'all both got it,
mm-hmm.
now you got to face who y'all are as people.
Yeah.
You have no distractions anymore.
You don't want me for my money. I don't want you for your money. We both get in the bag. Mm-hmm. Now we got to see if we like each other as people. I feel like Jay and Beyonce went through that phase. When he did the Kingdom Come album.
Yep.
He talked about the little split that they had. Like, yo, you're focused on your career. Go do that.
Yeah.
I need a wife. You leave, you get back. You figure out how to make it work. Because now the regular shit that we were into, that don't appeal to us anymore.
Right.
How are we as people together?
Right. And I feel like that's what a lot of people go wrong with, like, choosing partners and, like, deciding to get married to certain people. Like, when you decide to get married with somebody, like, and especially, like, for me, myself, like, this is a conversation I absolutely have had where it's, like, I want to make sure that I'm marrying someone that we're both, like, hand-in-hand locking in and we understand that we're going to evolve, we're going to go through changes, and we're still going to choose each other consciously every fucking day. Even on times in that, you know, I may not like the individual, but I still show up for that individual.
Yo, the simplest form of knowing if a marriage is going to work is you have to be with a person and you have to be in love with their being. And what that means is you have to look at that person and say, hey, over the next 20, 30 years, every different version that you're going to turn into, I already love her or I already love them. You know what I mean? Every version of you that's about to happen, I'm here for them.
Right.
People just want that version that they run into.
Right.
The person that they first met. A lot of people chase that. The version that they first met. It's never going to happen. It's never going
to
happen.
Changes every 3 to 5 years.
If I'm fucking, if I met you when I was 20, you think I'm going to be the same person when I was 35? When I'm 35? Like, no. It's just not how it works.
I'm not going to have the
shit. Apparently, you don't even like to go past 5 months.
I don't. But, I don't. After 2 years, it's like, get out of here. But, believe it or not, I mean, we're in America, obviously. We got everything here. We got everybody. A lot of relationships do fail because of cultural differences. A lot fail marriages too. Marriages and relationships, they do fail from cultural differences.
They fail from cultural differences and they fail from lack of communication.
Those are
the biggest reasons why people.
Because you gotta have some like common ground with your world, with your worlds, to at least try and make it happen. And if your culture is this and your culture is that. Sometimes it just don't work just based off that. Just straight off that. Sometimes it just don't work. Who knows? Like, for all I know, like, I don't know Jeezy. I don't know. What's his wife's name?
Jenny Mai.
Yeah, whatever. Whatever her name is. You know, I don't know them. You know, who's to sit here and say, like, that they really didn't, they really split from cultural differences?
Well, that was tea that was given. That's based tea, on, like, people who knew, like, people from their camp type shit. Like, you know, Atlanta, that's one thing about Atlanta. Like, everything. It's easy to get tea in Atlanta. Like,
if it don't come from anybody from Atlanta. Corporate Thug and Entertainment, I don't believe it. From but what? Corporate Thug and Entertainment was his record label. If it ain't anybody from there, I don't believe it.
Whose label?
Jeezy's. CTE, Corporate Thug and Entertainment.
Got it.
If it ain't from one of them, I don't even know any of the rappers' names, but if it ain't from one of them, I don't believe it. But Who says it's not cultural differences? Who says it's not? Who says...
It's just crazy. Oh, you know what was interesting, speaking of? And it's kind of getting off those topics real quick. So I had posted a Facebook post, and it was like basically saying, like, fellas, would you guys compromise on looks and go up in peace? And a lot of the men said yes. Okay.
Yeah, because it's like, wait, you're still fucking dating based off looks?
But hold the fuck up. Because I literally said... Fellas, she's a 5, but she is
ugly.
She comes with peace, cooperation, and can cook. What is she? A lot of these motherfuckers said that she's a 5, or, you know, she's probably the best friend, or she's like, thank God I got 5% tint. Like, all kinds of shit. Like, I
nah,
was
the
like,
the one that had me died and said she's a 5. What is she? Somebody said ugly.
Yeah, like what? I'm over here like, yo,
That's my boy, too.
I could have sworn that I literally just said a few days ago.
See,
like,
but, like, even for me,
if I'm going to be completely shallow, I will take a 5.5, but you have to be an upgradable 7. Like, I have to be able to, you better be a 5.5 in the house.
Yeah.
So
outside,
you're telling
you
me as long as
like
she can walk out the house and she
and
can be
look alright, then I can make the 5.5.
You better be a fucking catfish.
I can make the 5.5 work. Like, you gotta look fire in your pictures.
Yeah.
And like when we leave together, at minimum, women gotta be like, "Oh, you look like you did yourself up really." Now, like,
listen,
you wouldn't know you're putting effort to look good for me when we leave the house if you're a 5.5.
I can't.
But like for me,
outside of that though, I'm cocky. I need 7.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. For me as a man who really don't need anything like that. Like, cause I don't really give a fuck. You don't want to give me peace, that's fine. I'll just fucking go out. I don't care. But like, I need the eye candy. I need.
We're visual creatures.
That's what I'm saying. I need the beautiful girl next to me. So when I go out with you, I'm like, you see that? You see what I'm bagging? I got it like that. You know what I mean? I need the eye candy. You see what the fuck I'm bagging?
The difference between men and women is most of the times, y'all make a list for what y'all want based on either your surroundings, your culture, like the things you think you want in a man. Men
just look good.
We look at the woman first, and then we go, okay, how can I make her fit into my life?
Yeah.
We don't really, you know what I mean? Let's see if she has all these qualifications. It's more so, let's see how many of them she doesn't have, and can I deal with the ones she's missing, because I want that.
See,
that's how men put it together.
And like, for me,
hold on, bring that back? Yeah. What?
When y'all think of your ideal man,
yeah, I heard that part.
Y'all make a whole list first, and then you go, "Oh, and he gotta be good looking," or you look at the good looking dude and just hope he
embodies
that. I'm not gonna.
Men, we look at a woman and then we go, "How many of the things do I know she's missing, and can I deal with the things that she's missing? Because I want that."
But you also gotta understand.
It's really that simple. When any man that sits here and tries to lie and say no, he has a list of the things he require, then why do you have a past of bitches that you're not with? Because you would have vetted them better if you had an actual list, instead of just molding the list every time you seen a new fresh toy that you wanted.
Yeah, because even for me, I talk a lot of shit. So if I'm out, and it's like, and people see me, like, look at this nigga. He ran all his mothers to be with that fucking 5. You know what I mean? It just don't work like that. He talked all that shit to be with a fucking 5. But it's like, no, he talked all that shit, and he's with one of the baddest girls I've ever fucking seen. He's talking that shit. You know what I mean?
2 hours. What do you mean?
He's here every week. He's on YouTube. He's on TikTok talking all this fucking shit, and he's with that ugly ass bitch. That's what people are gonna say. I want the fucking eye candy. I'm sorry. Call me Shally and call me whatever the fuck you want on TikTok. Don't give a fuck. But that's what I'm looking for. And it's not with a trend, because women go for guys, whatever the trend is. Me and my good friend Juju talked about it. The new trend now is dreadheads. Dreadheads is the new trend.
Somehow that's a personality trait.
It's a personality trait. If you have dreads, I need you in my life.
It makes zero fucking sense.
Right, dreadheads is the trend now.
Again, what species of person is making this a trait?
Delusional women. But right, you know what I'm saying? That's a trend. But listen, right in the 90s, it was bald heads. Bald heads was a trend. I want a Tupac. You know, I want a Michael Jordan.
Let me tell you again, another thing that we're going to separate with men and women. But think about that. That's a trait. Oh, he got to have dreads. Somehow there's a personality attached to dreads, right?
Yeah.
Meanwhile, men, we're just warning people to stay away from those things. You don't trust the big button smile. That girl is poison.
Yeah.
We're like, hey, stay away from that. Women are like, that, I need it. Like,
yeah.
Somehow
you know, dreads do the best.
Somehow that's going to answer my problems. He has dreads.
Yeah.
I don't know who he is as a human being. He could be terrible, but he has dreads. So I'm going to give him a chance.
Yeah, like, what the fuck? He could be the worst fucking person in the world.
Yeah, the funniest.
But he has dreads, so it makes up for it.
I know somebody might try to sneak this because I'm bald. I'm going to let y'all know now. I've been bald since before dreads was a phase. I'm going to be bald long after dreads are gone. I'm still going to be.
What's going to happen when all these dreads start cutting their fucking hair?
They're going to find some different excuse of why. Then they're going to go back to the stars. Well, he's a Virgo.
It's me if I ever see my man do this trend.
It's all trends. It's all fucking trends.
No, he fucking did it.
Yeah. So you all just follow. It's all women's thing for men, what they're looking for. It's all whatever the fucking trend is. Whatever the trend is, and whatever, whoever.
Where do you think the trend's gonna go?
Next?
Mm-hmm. Y'all have to. I would hope y'all are gonna go up from here, because I would say this is women's rock bottom as a species.
Yeah, it's women's rock bottom.
I would hope y'all are gonna go up from here.
Yeah, like, I don't know. Why don't you just fuck?
Like, yo, that whole, what was the Tyler Perry shit?
What, his wigs?
What he was talking about.
Tyler Perry, if you see this, please call me. I got you. 65,000.
I hate that people do that to him. Listen. Like, he plays a good character, bro.
No. We're talking about everybody in his production.
They all have bad ways.
Yeah, you ever seen the Braids ones?
You ever seen the Shamar Moore one?
Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm saying. Call me. I have a certificate. We should really, like, take the certificate off the wall and hand it to it. But I have a certificate of completion that I have successfully completed a non-surgical, pain-free cranial prosthesis course, okay?
So, I'm sorry. What about Tyler Perry? Which one?
I forgot now. I was thinking about Shamar Moore and the Braids.
I'm a beast at it for the men, especially. So, like, call me.
I don't know. I don't honestly.
Nah, hold on. Nah, because those braids, I'm putting a picture of right now.
The, those braids. Of the Shema boy.
Those braids.
That's what I'm saying. Braids. They need to
then
call
he
me.
Have them, like, tied
JPS collection.
Wasn't it tied up?
Yeah.
We got the JPS collection. I can get you right with a nice little fake. All right,
that's.
Good wigs. I got you. Call me. Oh, JPS shit. Collection for the wigs.
He's still fucking going. Holy shit.
Jay Slay products for the curl. Yeah. For order. I got it. You need wigs? Order. Got it. JSlay.net.
Okay.
Plug it right here.
So.
JSlay.ig. JASLAYED. No, you know what's mad funny? What do you call it? When Kai Sinat lets the Instagram girls go on his stream. And they ask if they can plug in their thing, and he's like, yeah, and then he mutes them.
That nigga's funny.
Yo. Oh, man. No, that was funny.
All right, my point, right? Tyler Perry did an interview. He was saying some shit about how black women need to settle.
Oh, yeah.
So the point that he was making, I kind of get.
I got it,
woman,
too.
I think any woman that argues the point.
Is the problem?
No, you're not a problem. You're dumber than you think you are.
That's a problem.
I mean, that's I guess.
Is it really a problem? Or
yes,
is it.
Is
it a pandemic? Is it a pandemic?
It is, because it speaks to the
vast majority.
No, it doesn't speak to the vast majority. It speaks to the success of the things that were put in place. It speaks to the success of it. But pretty much what he was saying was, the way this country is designed, black men have the hardest time getting to the top, let's say 15%.
Yes.
It is a very hard battle for
Correct.
Us. It is an uphill battle. Someone that battle is not so hard for is black women. Y'all are some of the most educated people in the country. So that means, by proxy, you're going to end up being some of the better paid people in the country. Now your gene pool has, I mean, not your gene pool, but your pool to pick from has shrunk tremendously. If you're trying to keep things at your level.
Yeah.
Now you only got 15% of the population to work with, and all 15% of y'all are trying to fuck each other.
Because
y'all all trying to find y'all man in the thing. So let me tell these women, and also let me tell most women, ladies, that dream nigga that you keep dreaming up, that is so attainable, but in a small percentile.
Doesn't exist.
No, he exists.
He just ain't going to be married. Committed.
90% of the time he's married.
Oh, yeah.
And if you meet the nigga, he's married.
Yeah.
You're fucking somebody's husband. Look up numbers.
Or if
look
he becomes.
Stats. Look up the amount of people that make over $100,000 a year and how many of them are married.
Or if he does marry you, he gonna be fucking the mother bitches.
Yeah. And then are you gonna be able to deal with that?
Right.
They doubt it. Type of women. Like a certain type of woman to deal with that lifestyle.
100% doubt it.
I respect the ones that do. I really do. Because I get it. I get the standpoint of, yo, nigga, don't embarrass me. Nigga, don't bring nothing home.
Period.
I get it.
I always say, no embarrassment, no kids, no STDs. And let me live in my Delulu land.
Yeah,
and as long as the home is good, let me think that I am your only one. Don't give me no inkling, no nothing.
Your annual salary is peace of mind when you have that type of life.
Yeah.
Like, you get to be home and be a wife.
Yep.
And again, some people that's just a deal breaker for them, and I understand that. But for other people, it's yo, you're not gonna be home for 3 months.
Exactly. Especially,
I get it.
Gotta make this money. Especially you like your lifestyle.
Especially because I have like a lot of
loyal to Lulus.
Oh yeah.
Like the ones that'll let you fuck and they won't cheat to save.
Oh, I love them.
Oh, those are the best.
I love them.
She's at home being a good girl.
I love them.
Like, oh Lord, I'm gonna go home and fix every cabinet in the house.
I love them.
Like, you deserve some husband shit for the next week.
Like, yeah. Just a week.
Just the next week?
Just a week. You gotta breadcrumb them.
Jesus Christ.
You gotta breadcrumb them. You can't do everything all at once because then you're gonna fucking turn to papoose. So you gotta just fucking breadcrumb them.
Yo. Did you just... He just did some light skin behavior.
I'm gonna just cue the Braveheart beat.
He just did some light skin shit.
That was what? Super light skin.
That was really light skin.
What?
Bad
light skin.
What?
Nothing.
No,
so light skin, you don't even realize it.
Yo, you explain it. We explain it. No, explain.
You just did the most light skin shit.
What's that?
Just took a dig at my boy.
Yeah, why? What was that shot for?
Right. What he do to you?
Because he got cheated on.
Jesus. It is a secret.
Did he not? Is that not a fact? Is that not a punchline?
It's not a fact.
But it is a punchline.
Is it not a punchline?
Also, what we forgot to say, and we can get back off that topic, his silence is speaking volume.
Yes.
Because the man that we are, think about the man that we are describing him to be when it comes to his wife,
mm-hmm.
he would have been came to her rescue.
Absolutely. You're right.
Yeah. That's the part that's weird, is we haven't heard it.
That's what makes me believe that it's true.
That's the part that goes, Pat would have been right on any platform he got, talking about, yo, watch how you talking about my wife, da da da.
He would have pulled a Will Smith. Keep my wife's name out your fucking mouth. Hold on,
so, could be that, or, and what I think, because
he's about to drop a...
No, I'm just a conspiracy theorist. He knows all this shit is a roll-up.
Oh. Yeah.
For the battle league.
That's what I meant to say. Like, they're about.
It's all promo for the battle league, to draw people in. Now they want to know what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
What's the sneaky?
I don't know who the fuck these people were until that shit happened.
Me neither.
But listen, Geechee Gotti in that verse said that because he was like, when them Shade Room and such and such blogs talk about people, because he was talking about how Easy is like a nobody.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Talking to Remy, he was like, when them TMZs and them blog sites talk about your situation, they only know you. Like, he's like, bitch, mm-hmm. you're the one with the power in this situation. Like,
mm-hmm. Now, but that also goes to how people say, well, like, it's said that, you know, women who, like, are known and then they date down or are... But see, to me, I don't look at Pap like a down.
She didn't date down.
Right.
Would you consider that dating down, really?
That's not. I can't say that.
They were both at their peaks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
At that time, they were both at the height of their careers.
Right.
So that's not a date down.
That's what I'm saying. And, like, I don't know.
And financially either, because Pap is a smart man.
I was just about to say, like...
But, like, Nicki Minaj really dated not, down.
Well, yeah.
That's
a whole different level. Like...
But, yeah, let's be honest. Nicki Minaj dated down.
Right, that's dating like that's graveyard.
for some reason, Lotto, she keeps her boyfriend a secret.
Who?
Lotto.
Well, no, they say 21 Savage is her boyfriend.
It's me.
Huh?
You see how they say?
Because he's married and his wife is ready to divorce his ass and deport him.
I mean,
did we forget he's Britain?
Her.
I know, but
Lotto's boy.
He's been long enough, but he's also rich. She doesn't have that power over him. That doesn't work that way when you're rich.
Let's just be honest. Lotto's boyfriend's me. Lotto and Lotto. All
right. let's move on. So, about, all right. Do you guys feel as though that it's even worth it to get married?
No.
To get married?
No.
To have a union with a person? Yes. All the weird legal shit that somehow follows, I get a little icked out. But I think the ceremony and the meaning of marriage is amazing. Like, I do want to have like a ceremony with my wife. Like, I think we're gonna.
I ain't signing shit.
I think we're gonna do some type of something. Cause I feel like, again, also I do feel like that's for other people when you go through all that extra shit. Mm-hmm. But that whole legal shit, and because it just makes everything messy. Like, once you let, again, letting the government pimp you, once you let them into your fucking business, mm-hmm. they can dictate how it goes if it goes bad. It's the same thing with that lady that was like, yo, you all here wondering why you can't find a husband. It's because you belong to the government. The government's your daddy.
Government.
The government's your man. Okay. The government's paying your bills and giving you food. That's why he tells you what to do, where to go, and when to do it.
Yeah. I
do think the union of marriage is amazing. I think the legal shit is where it gets weird. I think that has nothing to do with being with your significant other. That's a business contract.
Yeah, I don't agree with none of that. I ain't signing shit. Not only that, and not only may not sign the shit, if shit does end well, I ain't giving you half my shit.
My thing is this, and I feel the same way about, I've said this stance on Valentine's Day, XYZ. Like, the vows of a marriage, you know what I'm saying? To love and to hold, to have, for good or for worse, for richer, for poor. If you need a piece of paper to tell you to do those things with that person,
don't get married.
You don't want to do those things with that person.
Okay.
Think about the people, think about the women that religiously, oh, if you want this and that, I gotta be your wife.
So you
should. Bitch, if I don't know if you could do it now, why am I gonna marry
that's
you?
That's what I'm saying. It's like a fucking guessing game. I don't got a ring on my finger. I don't got a ring. This is only gonna happen if you got a ring on my. If I have a ring on my finger, that's then fine. No, I ain't fucking
Felicia
doing
it. Felicia and Becky gonna do it for free.
Exactly. Exactly.
There's some women that don't give head unless they're like with the person. Gonna
well, she can head on out because it's not. You get the fuck out of my face.
I had a girl say that to me one time. She was like, "Oh," and it was the way she prefixed it. Well, not prefixed, but the way she like I set it up. She was like, "Oh, I would give you head, but I only give head to people I think I'm gonna marry." And I said, "So I just have to trick you into thinking that we're gonna get married, and then I can get."
Oh, that's easy.
Like, that's what you just told me.
That's easy.
Why do you? All right.
You just gave me the blueprint to get free head.
Fucking idiot.
Wait, I have a question. So do you believe that there are a lot of men that will sell the dream of marriage to women for women that they do not intend? Why?
Because we know how to do that.
Fair. So I went to college for 2 weeks. It was this girl. She was fucking bad. I was like 20. She was fucking bad. And I just had to get her. I just had to. So we're talking about having a conversation, good conversation and shit. She tells me she goes to college. Whatever. So I panic. So I'm trying to impress her. I'm like, oh, where did I go to college too? I said we went to the same college. And she's like, what do you study for? And I said a major. It was her major. So I'm like, oh shit. So I had to impress her.
It's
so I was going to college for 2 weeks. I had a backpack. I was walking on campus. I was sneaking into class. I was sitting next to her. I was even taking fucking notes. For 2 weeks, I was eating lunch in the cafeteria with her. We're walking. We're flirting all over the fucking campus. I didn't even fucking graduate high school. But here I am in fucking college.
He got his GED, though.
I did something similar.
And then 2 weeks passed. And then, like, because the whole time, I'm like, I hope you don't give us a fucking test. I hope they don't. And then after a while, after I, you know what I'm saying, I secured the bag. And I'm just like, yeah, it just wasn't for me. I think I might have to do next semester. It's just too much going on right now. So I went to college for 2 weeks.
That's your friend.
And the thing, no, so, but this is my thing. You know, this is my thing. Because, like, there's many stories like that that he could tell. The stories that I've heard. The stories that I could tell. Like, because y'all want the dream so bad, it's so easy to sell it to y'all. Pimps wouldn't exist if that wasn't the case. Their whole energy is selling a dream.
So how would you say, as a man that is capable of selling dreams and knows the gist about it, what are some things that women can, like,
learn?
Yeah, learn to understand whether or not they're being sold the dream of a man.
You'll never know.
Stop being delusional. Stop being unreasonable about what you want. Because the more unreasonable of the thing that you want, the more you're gonna jump at it when you think you see it. If you spend your whole life chasing Bigfoot, any 6'8" man that's hairy might look like Bigfoot to you.
Mm-hmm.
Because you want it to be true so bad.
Mm-hmm.
Not only that.
So if you want the dream of the riches and the success and the glitz and the glamour, the fancy cars and all of that, all I have to do is show up with all of that stuff. I don't even have to own none of it. If I show up with all of it, I am presented as what you think you want. Mm-hmm. Now it's how long can I keep up this facade to get what I want from you?
So,
and what is that timeline? Yeah. Do I get what I want before you realize that none of this is real?
Okay.
That's the timeline
so,
that women are constantly on with the men that are selling them a dream.
Now, as far as timeline goes, how long is would you say is an average that a man will keep up a facade?
Forever.
As long as we need to.
Forever. We could fucking last a lifetime.
You can pick a list of your four closest male friends on your phone and I could ruin one of those relationships in a heartbeat. By simply sending all the text messages saying, "Hey, come get this." The nigga you never thought would, I promise you.
That's great. You ever see the movie Sprung? It's an old 90s movie. It's probably like mid-90s. So it's an old 90s, mid-90s black movie, right? Mm-hmm. So there's one of the guys. So they're basically, one of his boys comes in town, like from whatever he was doing. They were college buddies. They're in L.A. So one of the guys, a friend who lives there, he didn't really have that much money. He was just an average working guy, you know what I'm saying, regular crib, whatever, right? They're going out on a night. Now, this is the 90s, by the way, which tells you shit really don't change. It just evolves. Shit don't change. It evolves. So what he's doing is he rented a Porsche. We're going out. I got me a nice suit. We're going to the club. I rented a Porsche. He's driving around in a Porsche. He rented for the weekend. Stops at an ATM. Looks at all the receipts. Oh, yeah. Puts this one in his pocket. Goes to the club. Girl sees him, pulls up in a brand new Porsche, right? He's in a club. He's talking to a girl. He reaches in his pocket, drops the receipt. She looks at it. She sees how much money he got. This is the 90s.
And now takes, she's mine.
Takes her home and fucks her because she thinks she hit the jackpot.
She wants the delusion so bad that she's willing to believe it.
And this is in the 90s. This is a 90s movie.
That's crazy.
Remember what he said about breadcrumbs earlier?
Yeah.
Breadcrumb them. Don't give it all at once because if you're too nice,
all I have is that breadcrumb. But that breadcrumb was enough.
Yeah, you just gotta plant the breadcrumbs.
No more bread.
You know what I mean?
That's crazy.
It was just this crumb, but the crumb got me here.
Look at that. Rent it foreign. Boom. Here you go. Airbnb.
That's
$400.
That's another $300.
Fake job. Boom. Fake income. Boom. Somebody's buying a different bank account. Boom. Here you go.
And that was kind of like I forgot what I was watching. I think it was Daily Wrap Up Crew. And they had a segment one time when the girl was talking about how, like, she met some dude and she thought that he was really lit and he was visiting or he would travel out to, I think, Houston back and forth mad times and shit like that. And turns out that he would just ball out when he was on vacation looking like he got it. And he really didn't have it like that.
Yeah, because I'm going home, so I get to have my fun and then I got to go back to my regular life.
That's crazy.
But we're selling you the dream because we know the dream is going to get us in your pants.
Do you know how bad if I wasn't a married and happy man, I would bust out Noel?
That's crazy.
You know what I mean? It's just, we know what it takes to get y'all. We know what it takes.
I just got what you meant by Noel. Like,
that's
why
my European counterpart. Jesus. Look, I'm doing it. That's how my hazel eyes, because then it really throws it all on for them. And they're like, oh my God, where are you from? Queens, bitch.
Well, you know, I see what I mean? You see what I mean? You gotta, this is
weed. And he's worked twice, by the way. Noel has two belts. Noel has two notches on
so you have a, so you have a fake.
That's how delusional women
so you have a fake name, too.
Yeah.
Nigga, it's his name backwards.
That's my European I have.
All right, Tan.
No, so my fake name's a little bit more.
No, I'm saying if he's gonna go on his name backwards, Tan.
So I do. No, I do have a.
Noel is my European counterpart. He only has two bodies, but Marcus has five bodies.
My name backwards is TNA. That's what I'm looking for. Tits and ass. So, but I do have a fake name.
I believe you.
And it. I mean, if I tell you, you'd be like, oh,
don't say it because
no, I'm not. But you'd be like, oh, it sounds fake. Oh, but no. If I tell you, no,
John Cena.
The fact that I'm not far off is crazy.
Michael John.
Shit, bro.
No, listen.
You know why? I gotta think of some name that a woman will go, ooh.
No, see, so no. This is what I gotta do, right? This is what I gotta do. I gotta give you the. I gave you that light-skinned nigga with the blackest name. That's what you gotta do, because it just throws you off. Like, Because it's quad. Yeah, like, because it happens sometimes. Nah, it happens. Like it happens sometimes where it's like you got a light skinned nigga, but like, but it's like the blackest name, and it's Deontay. Like, where the fuck did that come from? I know a lot of light skinned niggas named Deontay. I know a lot of light skinned niggas named Deontay for some reason.
Devon, like, no, Devon, like D.
Devon, I like you got to listen. The light skinned black names. You know what the fuck I'm talking about? Like a Devonte and shit, like. Like
her name was L hyphen A.
Yeah.
So this. So I want to play. I want to play this because it kind of speaks to what we was just talking about, and I thought it was actually really interesting because it really goes hits with the sentiment that we're talking about.
Narcissistic women and what's happened.
Hold on.
Did you see?
Created a generation of narcissistic women. And what's happened is the rise of social media and the rise of online dating and the rise of feminism has taught women that they are not to blame for any poor choices. Every poor choice is glamorized. So if you want to be a sex worker, it's great. If you want to post in bikini pictures online, it's fine. If you want to be in with it, every poor choice is glamorized. And every internal reflection is seen as gaslighting yourself. So they've even got terms for internal reflection to prevent it happening. And so what will happen is they are trained to not reflect on themselves because we've been told we've been oppressed for so many years. Now it's time to make sure we project. And so we don't take any accountability. And as a result, when we get into relationships, if we don't feel completely soothed all the time, he must be a narcissist. He must be a manipulator. He must be gaslighting. He, rather than I. And unfortunately, we've got an online market that caters to that wounded woman, that caters to that entitled woman, and caters to that narcissistic woman. And it's so wild to me that so many women talk about narcissism, but the society today is just catering to narcissistic women. If I post a picture online, a bikini picture online, there's nothing my husband can do that could compete with that level of accolade.
Attention.
Impossible.
The compliments, the attention, the messaging, that you're so sexy and beautiful, yeah. And all these different things from thousands or potentially
around
millions
the world,
of men.
Around the world.
Who have money and all these things.
Yeah, and there's nothing he can do. He can't post online and get the same reaction. And more so, he can't give me the same level of validation. So what's happened is we've created a setup in society that means men have to compete with a level of validation they can't compete.
I thought that was just like
yeah. Yeah, I seen that too. Peppa Pig made a lot of good sense.
She hit spot on.
Nah, again, absolutely.
She's speaking to the delusion.
But I said it, my first time I've ever been on here, I said women are the most narcissistic people on the planet. I've been said it. I said women are the most narcissistic people on the planet. First off, they can't even spell narcissist, but they throw the fucking word out like it's nothing. They can't even spell narcissist. I can, 2002 spelling bee champ, but they fucking can't. They can't spell narcissist, but they're quick to call every man in the world a fucking narcissist when they don't even look in the fucking mirror. Sometimes y'all gotta look in the fucking mirror. Sometimes you just gotta look in the fucking mirror and be like, I am the fucking problem. Sometimes you have to. We've all done it as men. We've all looked in the mirror sometimes. It's like, maybe I'm the fucking problem. Trust me. I say it all the time. I know I'm the fucking problem. Literally. I know I'm the fucking problem. Literally. Let me tell you something. I fumbled more bad women than some of these niggas have ever had in their life. I fumbled them. I'm basically fucking Adrian Peterson in his rookie year. How many times I fucking fumbled?
I don't watch sports like that.
But if you watch sports, Adrian Peterson fumbled a lot as rookie year, and that's what the fuck I do. I fumble a lot of bad women. I am well aware I'm the fucking problem.
Bad as in, like, good women or bad as in, like, badass bitches?
Badass bitches.
Okay, because there's a difference. And it's sad because...
Oh, like, I keep them. The bad women, I fucking keep them.
No, but I'm saying, like you know, like, that, we talked about it before. Like, the Lupe fiasco. Bitch bad. Like, you know what I'm saying? And a lot of women will say, like, I'm a bad bitch, but it's like, honey, that's not a fucking...
Congratulations.
You know what I'm saying?
Like everyone else.
That's not a cape to wear. Like, what are we talking about here?
It's No. Yeah, like, as far as, like, beautiful women, I fumbled a lot of them. Sometimes, and you know how many times I've looked in the mirror and I'm like, damn, maybe I am the fucking problem.
Hold on. I got a question.
Is that accountability? I
fumbled a lot of beautiful women. Were they all good women?
Probably not. Probably a bunch of dog shit. I mean, there's a reason. I think everything happens for a reason.
I think attraction attracts attraction.
Yeah, I think.
What do you mean? I mean, they say that we tend to date people that are a reflection of us.
Exactly.
Yeah.
That's exactly my point. Think about how much pussy he gets. That answer, that speaks to a lot. Exactly my point. That speaks to a lot of things. Think about the amount of pussy he gets. He's on this show.
Getting a lot more.
Once a week.
And I think you viewers who are finding him attractive and stuff, y'all got issues.
You're fucking sick. Because he's honest about it.
Listen.
And somehow women are looking at him going, that's who I gotta give the camera.
But see, listen.
Throwing it. Like how they do at Drake concerts. Man,
no names, obviously, but you seen it before we fucking aired. You seen it in action.
Oh my God.
You seen it. You clearly understand that I don't give a fuck, and that's the beauty of it, that you know I don't give a fuck. I don't give a fuck what I say, I don't give a fuck what I do, and maybe it's just a sex appeal. I think sometimes sex appeal goes a lot further than actually being attractive.
All right.
No, it's true. You ever look, like, listen, as a man, you ever look at a girl, and you're like, you know something, she's not the baddest girl, but there's just something about her where I'm like, I fucking want her.
From what I've been told.
That's what I'm saying. It's just a sex appeal.
I actually, even down to a lot of the football players and stuff, when we have these conversations and stuff, they will say, like, men tend to look at women, but then.
Remember my argument? What? That a bad bitch and Lizzo could walk into the same room and Lizzo will probably get.
Oh, yeah, it's almost sex appeal. No, it's not even about just that. But what I'm saying is that, like, men, each man finds something different about a female that they are attracted to. Like, it might be like the way she smiles, the way she tilts her head.
I said earlier, the list. I want that toy. Now let me start eliminating the things that I know she does not have that my other toy might have. I want that toy though, so let me find it. That's what we do. Oh, yeah. Her smile is amazing.
The
she
aura.
She got a nice stomach.
The aura.
Oh, I like her left ear.
It's an aura. Like, I've said some girls, like, she's not the baddest in the room. She's not the sexiest in the room, but she got those fuck me eyes, and I want it. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? That's a thing. She got those fuck me eyes. I want it.
But she got that smile that you know probably looks good when she's orgasming.
Yeah, like, you know what I'm saying? It's just a sex appeal thing.
So, I have a question. Now, if a female was to ask a man, what is it about me that you like? And he immediately goes to how genuine and, like, how pure her, like, her love and her heart for people and things of that nature. Like, damn, I forgot where I was trying to go with that question. Like, all right.
Saying, does that speak to her level of attraction if that's not the first place he goes to?
Yeah.
No, that's just a man trying to be coy. We want to go to the physical shit immediately, but that question always sounds like a setup, so we're going to start with some lighthearted shit before we be like, end that ass, girl. That's just...
Okay.
Like, with my girl, like, I'm boldly honest, and I'm just like, yo, my girl knows I love the person. But if she asks me a question like that, I'm going right to all the physical shit. Girl, have you seen your titties in the mirror? I'm going right to the physical shit. Have you seen your ass when you throw it back on me? Do you know what your face looks like when you give me head? Like, I'm going to all the physical shit, because I'm just like, yo, you know I love the person. But if you ask me a question like that, you're giving me a chance to express, to remind you all the little simple physical things
that I love about you. It's sex appeal. Like, trust me, like, you guys, y'all are saying, like, oh, like, you see what he's saying, you see him, but you still continue to fuck him. Like, I get it. Like, I might not be the most attractive man in the room. I might not be the richest man in the room yet, manifesting. But if any woman who talks to me, they'll say, this motherfucker oozes with confidence. He's very fucking sure of himself, and he's fun. Because women like fun. Yeah. They don't like boredom.
My count with this?
Yeah.
Listen here. I had this my whole life.
Yeah.
My numbers is great.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
That's what I'm saying. Like, it's just
I
like...
I learned how to use this to my advantage.
He's just... Like, girl, he's you know what I'm saying? It's just like... He's oozing, like, you have a con. Anybody who has a conversation with me, like, this motherfucker is very sure of himself.
Girl, all time. You ever see a boxer on a speed bag?
Nah.
Yes, sir.
Like,
gap 2 Galileo, baby.
Oh, yeah. I got the gap 2.
What's up?
Gap 2 Galileo, Lazy Eye, Leopold, bald headed Beethoven. I can go for days.
You have
girl.
A lazy eye?
Huh?
You have a lazy eye?
Can't tell, it's very faint, but I know because again, I'm very self aware.
Wow,
I just got...
that way. Listen, only 3 people know I have a lazy eye because it's very faint. Mm. But if somebody was like, and you got a lazy eye, I'm like, bitch, I know.
Those are good. I just call myself the green eye bandit.
The green eye bandit.
But
each one of those little nicknames I came up with, finding those things out about myself.
Yeah,
so like Gap 2 Galileo, I've been saying that since high school. I've been saying Gap 2 Galileo since high school. Lazy Eye Leopold was high school, and when I shaved my head, it was the bald head Beethoven. Like, I will always find a way to flip some shit physical about myself. Cause my, never mind.
Yeah, but that's just what it is. Like, you can have a conversation with me. You act like you're talking to fucking Floyd Mayweather. Like, this guy, who the fuck does this guy think he is? I know. But it's just like, you think you're talking, but actually, you know what I'm saying? It's like, you're talking like this guy is the most fucking confident person.
How tall?
Yeah, he is. He's so, but you know what I'm saying? But it's like, you're talking to fucking Michael Jordan. Like, this guy think, you're talking like, I'm talking like I got fucking 6 rings.
Oh, no, I tell people all the time, I'm the tallest person in the room when you let me open my mouth.
Yeah. Oh, my God, you let me open my mouth, forget it.
When you start letting me speak, especially if I know I'm in a room full of people I'm smarter than, I'm the tallest nigga in here. You can't tell me a damn thing. I'll make every nigga in here feel inferior.
But, like, I've also been in areas, venues, events, whatever. I've been in places where there's a lot of guys, there's a lot of girls. There's probably guys who women probably think, you know, more attractive than me. Probably guys have more money than me. Ain't nobody fucking talking. Ain't nobody talking to each other.
Niggas don't got games.
Guys are talking to guys, girls are talking to girls. I come in there, boom, fuck them niggas. I'm going here and I'm bagging something. That's what the fuck I do.
Do you want to know why most of the women that date the scammers and the drug dealers and all of that stuff don't really last in relationships?
Because they don't know how to.
No, it's because they realize that you can't buy game.
Yeah.
You cannot buy swag. You can have height and money. If you are a corny nigga, you are a corny nigga.
Yeah. No, that's facts.
You can't buy swag.
Yeah.
Absolutely facts.
It's true. Trust me.
How many movies and cartoons and shows have we seen growing up where the nerdy kid, like, tries to reinvent himself and he has all his catchphrases?
Yeah, it's called Love Don't Cost a Thing.
Love Don't Cost a Thing? didn't they do it on Ed, Edd n Eddy?
Yeah.
I like to turn Ed into a fucking,
I'm not gonna lie.
Like, that's an age-old thing, but it's like, what always happens at the end of that shit? It crumbles and the real nigga shows.
Yeah. But that's just what it is. Like I said, I've been to events in places where There's guys, there's girls, and they're not there. They're just not talking to each other. It makes me fucking pissed. But I like it because it's like, y'all do that, I'm going here, and I'm gonna choose. It's like fucking Chris Tucker and Rush Hour when the fucking curtain opens. He's like, I want that one. That's what it is. Y'all ain't talking? All right, I'm walking in, and I'm talking. I'm bagging something. Cause that's just what I do. Fuck y'all niggas. I'm bagging something. I came here for them. I didn't come here for y'all.
I used to be a salesman. I know how long the average is. I'm leaving with
something. I didn't know
how the law of averages
works. I didn't come here to talk to y'all niggas. I came here to talk to them women. And that's exactly where I came in, and that's exactly what I'm doing.
See, there's 60 women in here. That's 60 doors to knock on. So yeah. Let's get to it.
It's like speed dating. Like, y'all
ain't talking. Say that you clear off by 5% for men?
Exactly.
Most men are able to successfully get 5% of whatever the probability may be.
Yeah, that's about 5%.
Yeah. Well, 5 people. But that's just what I... That's
if,
just,
I talk to, if I talk to 100 women in a day, I'm bagging 5.
Yeah.
Minimum. I mean, my number would be a little bit higher, but that's just because
I understand.
I have the gift of gab. But the average man talks to 100 women, he's getting at least 5.
Yeah, definitely. But it's just like,
whether you do it over the course of one night, one month, one week, if you know your number and you keep failing, that's a way to give yourself a hope of success. Like, yo, I'm at 94. I mean, these next 6 women, something's got to give.
Right. So you know what I say.
And if that doesn't work, then just like a salesman, you go back. And you re-perfect your pitch.
Right.
You re-perfect your rebuttals. Mm-hmm. You re-perfect everything.
Yeah.
You got to work on your fear of loss. You got to work on all of the tricks of the trade when you're making a sale in order to have that success. It's the same thing when you're spitting games to a woman.
Yeah. Shoot is shoot.
I mean, the market is created for women to
You miss 100% of the shots you don't take. Shoot is shoot.
There's no 100% NBA three-point shooter, but there's a lot of great NBA shooters.
Yeah.
Got it.
Like,
you know what I'm saying?
Me, I'm not scared of rejection.
Steph Curry, which is the greatest shooter in history,
it's like 45%, something like that. Yeah, it's 45%.
It's not even over 50.
Yeah.
But we know him for what?
Shoot.
Making the shot. Because he takes the shot. It's the same thing.
Like, yeah, trust me, I'm known for getting girls. You know how many girls denied me?
And I think, we're personally speaking.
They deny you to spin back. I don't even want to hear that.
Yeah, that's a weird thing.
But see, no.
They deny you at first to make themselves feel better about the bad decision they're about to make.
Literally, like,
but
I've watched it.
But
like, I've been knowing this guy since I was 15 years old. I watched it
from a place of privilege because we are 17
years
of confident men that have no problem speaking to.
And we don't care. We don't care if we get them. We don't.
A lot of men don't though. A lot of men are wary, especially in this day and age, because you can try to talk to a girl and you're gonna get called 17 different types of.
Nah, I'm just like, I don't care.
Assaulters and all types of shit. But for that average man, he has to stick to that 5 to 100. He has to. And that's the most realistic number you can give yourself. You can't sit there and say, I'm going to talk to 10 women. Now, these 10 women, at least three of them are going to come home with
you. It's not how it works. That's not how it works. You got to talk to a lot.
Only the best of the best can get a percentage like that. And even they have to do more than the average man. They have to have more money. They have to have more height. They have to have these things. If you are the average man, the 5'9 to 5'11 average man, $50,000 to $60,000 a year, and a fucking Altima average nigga, your number is 100 to 5. That's your number. But that, like, that's your number. That's your realistic number.
But I seen something, right? And obviously, this goes back to the delusion that y'all think. It was a post on Facebook. Well, not y'all, but y'all.
I be doing that to my girl all the time. Like, yo, not you. Y'all be like,
some girl posted and was like, all men eat girls' pussies the first link. All men. I said,
that's crazy.
I said, first off,
the whole culture of men that don't do that
shit. Not only that, I said, there's only about 25% of men, maybe even smaller. I don't know the exact percentage. But there's only like 25% of men who are actually like sexually active.
Yeah.
So you're talking about all men when it's only like 25% of men, and on top of that, there's an entire culture of men who don't even do it. So
couple of cultures.
So now you're even narrowing down that percentage. So that's just delusion.
One nasty ass niggas you fucked with.
Yeah. Right. The nasty niggas you fuck with is eating every girl's pussy.
The first link is crazy.
That's crazy. That's absolutely insane.
I've done it.
Now that I'm older, that's absolutely insane. That's crazy.
I've done it, yeah.
I've never done it.
But you know what I'm saying? But that's like, insane. Sit here and,
I'm not just out here throwing
the tongue. To sit here and think that's the entitlement insane. That all men are getting pussy is fucking crazy. Because y'all are all getting dick.
It's easy for y'all to get. Yo, somebody said something. It's relevant to this conversation. But somebody was talking about the Papoose and Remy shit.
Mm-hmm.
And they showed a picture of Remy that she had like this black lace joint on.
Yeah.
Yitty's just out.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And she was standing there with Papoose. And he said, when your woman dresses like that with you.
What were you watching? Coach Greg Adams?
Nah. It's Corey Holcomb.
Yeah, I like Corey.
The person on his show was like, if your woman, Corey Holcomb actually was like, if your woman dresses like that, not only does she not respect you, she's putting you in a room full of
vultures.
Opposition, and she's wearing their jersey.
That makes sense.
You get it.
I get it.
Dressing like that, and then you walk in a room of men.
Yeah.
You have now put me in a room full of my opposition, and you have on their jersey.
I understand what you're saying.
You're giving them.
Look like you are obtainable to them.
Yes.
Now I have to, even whether if it's physically, whether it's verbally, whether it's through eye contact, whether it's through stance, whether it's through my
he aura, has to.
I have to defend myself now.
Yeah.
You can't even be comfortable.
No, you are not to be approached.
Right.
And
but you don't look like that's what the energy you want from me.
Right.
You look like you want the thirsty ass energy from them.
Right.
You're a representation. That was a great fucking. He was like, you are.
Putting and not me, only that.
You're putting me in a room full of opposition.
You're taking away the moment of us having a good time. To me having to keep my fucking guard up.
Yeah.
Now my head gotta be on a swivel now, cause I know my girl look good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I gotta look like this, I look like that.
I know if I saw you in this shit, I'm shooting my shot.
Mm-hmm.
So now my head gotta be on a swivel.
So now you're in defense mode.
Now when you go to the bathroom, it ain't got nothing to do with trust. It's more so, yo, these niggas is gonna dog you or try to get their hands on you from the time you walk away from me to the time you come back.
Mm-hmm.
Because in our head, like, we're logical. We're logical people. We know. Cause we are those people. We are those men as well. If you got 100 niggas in your DMs, you mm-hmm. think you're ignoring 100? No, you're not.
No, you're ignoring 95.
What you mean?
Yeah, you're ignoring
95.
Hold on.
Five of those niggas is going to say something slick to you to the point where you at least respond with an LOL. And if you at minimum respond with an LOL, he's in.
I don't agree to that.
Yeah, you wouldn't.
Huh?
But it's true. But it's true.
No, because not for nothing. Like, for me, I, no. When I'm with someone, I'm just with that person.
No, and there are women that are.
And then, like, at the end of the day, what makes it tricky for me, and I will admit to this, it makes it very tricky for me is when a guy will, like, hit up my DM, and they're like, hey, how are you? I don't know if they're approaching me for business or if they're trying to be funny. But I've had guys start with the hey, how are you? And I see their profile. They look like they have hair. So I'm expecting that they're going to ask me a hair type question. Because that's right. As soon as they continue on, I make it very known and very clear. Like, are you looking for, you know what I'm saying? But hold on, though. I do have male clients that I've had for years and we're mad cool and shit. And if they send me something on like Instagram or if they send me something on Facebook and stuff, like I may reply with a LOL or whatever, but like there's still that boundary
exactly. But that's your boundary. That's not theirs. So the point that we're making is if I get a response out of you,
I'm in.
Even if I don't stay in, even if you kick me right out.
Right. I was about to say, but
went through the door.
But for me, that makes it weird because it's like a lot of them, they're just homies. Like I've known them. I worked in a barbershop for so fucking long. So it makes it hard.
I understand that. That's fine. And some women out there are actresses that work with male stuff or whatever.
Yeah.
They're still a married woman. They got to go home and answer to their husband for certain shit.
Yeah.
That's where it is. And that's where women have an issue because instead of just admitting, yo, yeah, I might slip and talk to one or two of them because I thought what they said was cute or whatever the case may be. Instead of admitting that, mm-hmm. they make men the issue so that they never have to face it. And they, oh, well, you're insecure or you got to do this or you're worried about that. And it's just like, yo, just admit that the nigga got the best of you. We can work with that. I can work with a nigga. As a nigga with game, I can understand game getting a nigga's foot through the door. Mm-hmm. Now I got to see where your loyalty lies because it's your job to shoo that nigga back up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And most women won't. So instead of facing with that, they make other things the problem. Because, oh no, I have a right to just talk to him if we're not doing nothing. No, you don't.
Right.
You're giving a nigga energy. That's a problem. Mm-hmm. That fucks with my energy. A lot of people don't know how energy strings works. When you have energy strings with a human being, it gets weaker the more people you start attaching strings to.
Right, yeah.
I could feel that. You're my woman. Mm-hmm. I know when you're talking to a nigga because I know how you act when you like a nigga. Mm-hmm. Or I know whatever smirk you make on your Instagram while you're scrolling, oh, somebody just said something to you, or somebody just liked the picture you really wanted a like on. Mm-hmm. I know what that looks like. Mm-hmm. I can feel that energy. We have a string. So
now,
you lying to me is going to weaken this fucking string even more.
Yeah.
Not only that, I know how it was when we first met. You know what I'm saying?
I was waiting for him to say that.
You know how I know
what worked.
I know it worked. And what he's doing is how the same way I got you. So he must know the blueprint.
And if I know the blueprint, I know when I see the blueprint.
Yeah.
That's my move. I do that.
Yeah, like, because, you know I mean? Because like, because we try a whole bunch of methods with different girls. Just because, once again, y'all post everything out there. So we're looking, we're watching, and we're like, okay, so I'm going to approach her like this. Mm-hmm. I'm going to approach her like that.
What's that thing called when they
research?
I heard like a man
track the serial killers. What do they call it? Profile. We profile.
No, it's funny because they say usually men will know a female for 6 months before she met him for one day.
If I'm walking at an anime convention and I see a girl that I find attractive, mm-hmm. I'm gonna scope the scene real quick, mm-hmm. and I'm gonna find my entry point. It doesn't matter what the girl is. It doesn't matter if the girl is a nerd. It doesn't matter if she's a successful businesswoman.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter if she's a nurse. It don't matter if she's a barista at fucking Starbucks.
We'll find the common ground.
Girl, don't nobody on this planet make a caramel macchiato like you. I don't know what you do to it.
Yeah, we'll find the common ground. We will find it. Yeah. Listen, we know what shows you like. We know what music you like. We know you went to the Drake concert last month. Like, mm-hmm. We know everything.
And I'm going to use that. I'm going to walk in and get my regular caramel.
Damn, so then that.
I'm like, damn, girl, you're still here? What you mean? You went to the Drake concert and you trying to tell me out of all the women he didn't try to take you home?
I didn't mean that. Yo, I heard for all the dogs is dropping.
Way he didn't try. You got his number.
Like, oh, you heard that? Oh, you heard that new Drake shit?
You know me with Drake? I'm a big you. Now you in your head, oh, I'm good enough for Drake. Oh,
yeah.
My God.
Yeah. Like, stupid, you ain't even fucking.
Sorry, I get mad when it works.
Like, stupid, you ain't even. It'd be like, stupid, you ain't even good enough for 40. Get out of here.
Yeah, I get mad when it works. That's all.
Yeah, but it's like, you know what I'm saying? Like, we're watching everything you're posting. We know what you like and what you
don't. And because we know that, we know other niggas are doing the same thing.
Yeah, other niggas.
Me and my girl can't even, like, see some shit that, like, on Instagram that we might find cool or interesting or relate to, and it could be, like, talking bad about a relationship or nothing. One of us post it, and just the most views I ever get on my IGs when people see just them letters.
Yeah.
When people see just them letters, they swear to God I'm always talking about my girl. And I'm just like, yo, fam, I just be writing shit. Like, 10% of what I put on my IG is my real.
Not only that, and I'll tell you right now, I know 5 niggas off the top of my head who's doing a profile on 2 just like me.
That's what I'm saying. So
I know 5 niggas off the top of my head right now. Just,
I can not say nothing to my girl all day. I could look at her IG post and I can tell which one is going to garnish a man responding to it.
And 2 of them are on this show.
Like, I could look at her post and go, oh, somebody's gonna hit her up off that one. She don't even gotta be in it. She could post a picture of Meg Thee Stallion twerking. And there's gonna be some nigga in her DMs. Or, I wish I could see you doing that. Like, just dumb shit. Just dumb nigga shit.
Just, you seen the like? He's doing the same shit. You seen the like? He's doing the same shit.
Cool.
Juju.
Oh.
He's liking Kike's shit too.
Oh, he's trying to crack it too?
You didn't see it? He's liking her shit too.
Oh, so you guys are both. Wait, how the hell did he come across her?
I don't know.
Coming at that shit from both angles.
No, I don't know.
Intended. I love this though. I'd even send him. That's the crazier part. I sent him, not the other one.
They come as a pair.
I swear.
We're trying to figure. We're both trying to crack this code.
All right. We got 3 minutes left.
Okay. All right. So, last but not least, I wanted to talk about Krishan and Blueface.
Like, share, subscribe. Send us your comments.
Yeah. Krishan Jr. She named herself.
What's wrong with that? Men do it all the time.
I gotta see that again afterwards.
Men do it all the time.
No, what? But she named her son a junior.
Name sounds like a male name.
It does.
Krishan.
But she named her
it's
son.
It's literally 2 male names, Chris and Sean.
Yeah.
Krishan. That doesn't. What's the problem?
All right, now. And the whole, like, Blueface going back and forth between his both baby mamas. I swear he's from Providence.
All of that stuff is fake, though.
I understand, but I really think that they're from Providence at this point.
All that stuff is no, you think that because how they act is very fucking common. That's why.
Yo, it's sick.
You see it every day.
It's sick.
Yeah, that's all it is. That's all it is.
Different than the couple in the hood. I say the same thing. Never mind. They're no different than the couple in the hood, man. They're just a couple. They're going through couple shit, and I think everybody needs to stop living their lives in the public eye.
Yes.
Because nobody's perfect. So the more that you give us your imperfections in our face, the more we get the fucking pick out.
And also, the more attention you're giving it, the more outlandish shit they're going to do because they know you are paying attention to it.
There's no peak for them. There's no peak.
It's sad. We really, I don't know what to do with this society.
There's no peak because then what's the reward for them being private? Normalcy? Oh my God. God forbid.
Blueface don't even make music no more because he's getting all his money off this shit.
Yeah.
That's a good question to close out with. The conversation of toxicity within relationships, right? And a lot of times, like, you could even want to go into a relationship with peace and, like, you could want to go into a relationship with peace and you do your best to do so, but then, like, as time goes on or whatever, like, your partner, they just make it very difficult for there to be peace. Like, their action causes a reaction.
If it got to that point, that's your fault for staying that long.
Yeah.
You should have got out of Dodge when you saw that things were changing and not for the better. But again, as humans, we try to stick the fuck around because we think we can
But, I mean, what about the loving the different versions of the person as they're growing?
Then that means you're not meant for that person if you don't love those versions. That's what I was saying earlier.
No, but I'm saying, like, the actions and reactions, it just, like, it's...
But love and actions and reactions are different. If I have to react to your love, that's not love. That's a trauma bond.
Okay.
Because if I love you on Monday, and I'm upset with you on Tuesday, and then I'm fine again on Wednesday, but now you don't love me because of how I felt on Tuesday, then you're not prepared for all versions of me.
Yeah. This is all it is.
And if that's the case, that's okay. But we cannot survive. Because that means that when I'm at my lowest, it causes a problem for you.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Just and it's true because for some reason, they always say, for some reason, every girl has mood swings. A whole woman with mood swings, no way. But they're like, oh, can you fucking handle my mood swings? If I like you enough, yeah. I don't give a fuck.
That's an excuse because she knows she's about to do some fuck shit.
I know, and I can't wait for it. Because she don't want
to leave. All right, guys. Like, share, subscribe. Make that bell ring. Come join us next week. Hopefully, I know we've been acting up with our drops.
Man, life been life.
But, like, this is new setup, guys. There's more. Just wait. J Slay is going to come with a whole new revamp. You know, jslay.net. We're going to plug it in again. JASLAYED.net. Subscribe.